all in front of me. I just had to go get it. Look. Look.
Said I'ma make bail tonight. I'ma cause hell, I might. Roll through the city, bad little bitty. She gave me head on sight. And I got a safe route, a safe. I'm tryna make it out. Won't do the shit for clout. Come get with me, come get with me. I'm from the floor, see. I'm with them killer niggas, come and talk to me. You could try to walk with me, but you can't step in my shoes. I'ma clear the room, I'ma go boom. I got the anger, pain. I still sip champagne. 30 shots. Crowd the whole damn spot. I got a whole lot to lose, but I got a whole lot of shots. Rolling and controlling, doing what I do. Breaking rules might make them. Don't be a stupid nigga, play you a fool. And I show you what I'm in. How the fuck you say a nigga changed up? You was trying to get your name up.
Hey, what's going on YouTube? I hope you guys really enjoyed that cinematic edit piece in the beginning of the video. If you were wondering who that is my wife who was working out. You can follow her on Instagram here. And comment below, let me know how you like that video. How did you like that video edit? So in today's video, I want to go over how to shoot epic, dope, cinematic workout videos. Now, I'm not just talking about videos where you may like record your set and you have the camera sitting on a tripod, or maybe like you're recording some type of follow along workout for YouTube. I'm talking about a video where if somebody was to look at it, they would be able to tell just instantly that you were trying to put some type of effort. Maybe there's a storyline to it. The visuals just look a certain type of way where it kind of sets it apart from just the normal things that you may see on YouTube, online, or on Instagram. So I'm gonna hook you up. I'm gonna give you 7 of my tips that I keep in mind when I'm filming these type of videos. The only thing I ask from you before we get started is to just go ahead and hit that like button for me. I would really appreciate it. Let's get into the tips. So for the first tip that I have to say is that when you're recording these type of videos, or you plan to record these type of videos, have the song in mind which you're gonna use. At least that's how I start off. That pretty much just starts the ball rolling for my entire process. That's because when I have the song in mind, I can kinda like think in the way in which I wanna record. Like if you follow me on Instagram, or if you've seen any of my videos, you know like I like to edit to the beat. So if I already got the beat, the melody, the tune, the song in mind, I can kinda visualize my video as I'm recording. For example, the video with my wife that started off this video, you know, you saw her walking out, and as the song started, it was like, I always get caught in the rain. It's like, I was literally, we were at the gym maybe like the day or the week before, and I was listening to that song, and I was literally walking that same path, you know, that she was walking in the beginning. I was walking behind her, and it's like the song literally had just started at that moment. And you know, as you saw, like you see the gym, and it's just like you see all the people and stuff. And I was like, you know, just looking at her walking behind her, hearing the song, and I'm like, dang, that was kind of hard. Like that, you know, that joint kind of was a little tough. Like that would be a nice intro to a video. And then I was like, So number two would definitely be have a shot list, have some clips, some ideas in your head or written down that you wanna capture when you're recording your video. So that way, you know, you make sure that you check your boxes, you won't forget what it is that you wanted to capture. Now for the third tip, we're actually moving into filming the video. And what I've learned like over the years, I've been using like DSLRs and mirrorless cameras for about 3 years now, since 2018. And one thing I know, like when you're trying to film a video, if you hold the camera just like the standard way, or you got your hands on both sides, you know you're going handheld, it's gonna be a little bit more wobbly than usual, at least for me and my big hands. Now, a better option on how to record is instead of holding the camera like this, you can hold the right hand, you know, on the grip of the camera and actually put your left hand on the bottom of the lens, because, you know, when you're panning and you're doing all of this, it's gonna come out a little bit more stable than doing this, because, you know, I use the A7 III with the heavy Sigma 24-70, so it's so front heavy that naturally, like, there's gonna be just a little bit more shake. So when you're filming, make sure you have a nice grip on the bottom of the lens, especially if you have a nice big lens. That way, you know what I'm saying, you can be moving with the person, and then the video, you know, quality is just gonna look that much better. So I'm gonna actually put tips number 4 and 5 together. Now, number 4 is when you're filming, make sure you film multiple clips of the same exercise and film them in different ways. You know, as you saw when my wife was doing the workout in the beginning and she was doing the seated row, I had like the ankle from the side, the top side, the back, you know, and when you're filming, you always want to like end the clip a certain way, because number five is, like I mentioned earlier, you want to plan those transitions. So you don't really know exactly, you know, what you're going to be feeling when you edit, but you want to give yourself options. So, you know, you may want to just end the clip going down, or you want to end the clip going up. You may want to get a close up of the weight moving up and down, because, you know, in post-production, it's going to give you just that many more options to choose as far as, you know, exercise selections. Which angles do you like better? And filming different frame rates too. Now, speaking of frame rates, that's actually the number six thing I wanted to touch on. Now, when you're filming any type of video that you want to feel cinematic or be cinematic, 24 frames per second is what you want to film in. That's because, you know, that's that natural motion blur that your eyes used to seeing. And when you render it, you know, it's just gonna look the best, especially for these type of workout videos. Now, when you're filming the exercises, like I said, you want to make sure you get different angles. You also want to make sure that you get different angles at different frame rates. Like I said, it's all about planning, having that shot list. When you have transitions in mind, you're going to make sure that you film with those transitions in mind, like I said, but that may have to, you know, involve you switching the frame rate, because, you know, if you want to slow something down, you should already know that, you know, you're going to have to go to 60 frames per second. Second, you're going to have to go to 120 frames per second, and, you know, you're going to have to change your settings. But if you want it to come out right, you're just going to have to keep that in mind. That's where that shot list comes in. And the number seven thing is something that I already mentioned, which is pretty much in getting multiple shots. Don't be afraid to punch in. Don't be afraid to get a close-up of the hands or the weight, like I said, going up and down. And just the more you record, you know, when you do these videos over time, you'll realize that the more you record, even if it's the same thing, the more of a variety of like different angles of the same thing will allow you to like put together a video that is really so simple. But like I said, the variety of clips and how you put it together with the right music and everything just popping will just instantly show the viewer like, hey, this was, you know, some effort was put into this. This was like well thought out. And if you really knock it out the park with the song selection, the exercise selection, just the transition selection, you're really gonna make, you know, some original dope content that I'm sure you'll be proud of. Now, the next time I try to record, you know, a dope cinematic workout edit, I'm gonna make sure that I'm not actually working out while I'm doing it, because trying to switch settings and making sure my framing and everything is right, my lighting, my, you know, my ISO, making sure I'm not underexposed and all that while working out, it's really, really hard, especially when you got like pre-workout going through your system, your adrenaline pumping, and you just putting the camera up, you know, picking the camera up, putting it down, and all this other stuff. It gets a little complicated, because in that video in the beginning, there were some portions of the video that were underexposed. They weren't in focus. And, you know, when I went back and edited, I'm like, dang, I kind of messed up. But, you know, like I said, repetition is key, man. Just keep at it. You got the tips. You know what to do. So let's make it happen, man. So that's why I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. I really hope that you guys found some type of value in this video. I hope you're able to utilize these tips that I laid out. And comment down below, is there something that I'm missing? Are there some other tips? You have any tips for me? Let's go ahead and start a dialogue in the comment section down below. And if you guys did appreciate the video, go ahead and give it the old thumbs up. I would really, really appreciate it. Subscribe for more fitness content, tips, tutorials, videography content. And until my next video, I'm gonna catch you guys later on. Peace out, baby.